Good day! Welcome back to De La Cruz Engineering Videos, your supply of pasteboard solutions. And for this video, we will be solving this recently seen transmission tower problem on the CE board. So before we start, if this video helps you a lot, please subscribe to our channel and follow us on our Facebook page to be more updated on our future videos. So here is the problem. Refer to the transmission tower shown. The questions are, which of the following gives the resultant reaction at B? Which of the following gives the force in member AC? And which of the following gives the force in member FJ? This one. Okay, so actually my choices ito. Kinuha ko to from the book of CA Reference 4 by DIT Gilisanya. Okay, you can check this problem on that book. Okay, So we want to calculate the resultant reaction at B, so we have to draw the free body diagram. So here we have a roller support at A and a pin support at B, so the free body diagram should be like this. We have the normal reaction at A, and on B we have two reactions, okay, the vertical and the horizontal component of that reaction, okay? And for number one, the resultant reaction at B should be the resultant of these two reactions dito. And that should be like this, okay? RB. Okay, so how to calculate that? So first, we need to calculate first the components. Okay, so we can calculate first the BH dito. Okay, by summation of forces horizontal, as you can see. And we have these horizontal forces here. That will be 4 plus 6. Plus 6 minus BH is equals to 0, of course. Okay, and we have BH equals 16 kilonewtons. Okay, now, how to calculate the vertical component of B? That is by summation of moment about A should be 0. Okay, so we have 6 times 3.2 plus 6 times dalawang 3.2 or 6.4 plus 4 times tatlong 3.2 tatlong 3.2 which is 9.6, then yung BV will cause a counterclockwise rotation about A, so that is minus BV times dalawang 5.8 or 11.6. Okay, so we have 8.276 kilonewtons. Okay, now we can calculate the RB na by Pythagorean theorem. That will be square root of 16 squared plus 8.276 squared, and that is 18.014 kilonewtons. Okay, so that is the answer for part 1. So let's calculate na lang muna yung reaction at A, because on the second question, we need to calculate in member AC, so we need this, the reaction at A. Okay, and that is just by summation of forces vertical. As you can see, the vertical forces involved is RA and the vertical support at B. Okay, so we have RA plus RBV is equals to, of course, that is negative 8.276 kilonewtons. Okay, so our assumption here is correct, meaning yung reaction at A will be going down, but we will not change the direction na lang, ha? We will be consistent on what we get. So dito, negative 8.276 yung nakuha natin, consistent na tayo dyan. Gamitin natin yung signs. Okay. Now, how to calculate the force in member AC for number 2? The best option is at joint A. Okay? We have, look at this. At joint A, we can expose these forces here. That is force AC, and we have this force AI. Okay. Now, before that, we need to calculate the angle of inclination of this force. And as you can see, we can use this right triangle here. Okay, by a tangent of that angle is equals to the opposite, which is ito, tatlong 3.2 divided by 4.8. So we can calculate that angle dito. And that is 63.43 degrees. Okay, so how to calculate the FAC? That can be solved by summation of forces vertical, should be 0. So the forces involved here is the vertical component of this FAC. Okay, so we have the vertical component is FAC sine of this angle. Then of course plus, but we need to maintain this sine convention, minus 8.276 kilonewtons. Okay, kaya hindi na lang natin binaliktad yung force dito para consistent na tayo. So we have the answer 9.25 kilonewtons, and that is positive, meaning that is in tension. Okay, that is for part 2 to. Okay, that is for part 2. Na mistype ko. Okay, now for part 3, which of the following gives the force in member FJ? Okay, so let's go back to the original figure. Which of the following gives the force in member FJ? Okay, in this problem, yung force natin, I mean yung member na we need to calculate is andito. So medyo komplikado dito kung gagamitin natin yung method of joints. So we need to use the method of sections dito. Okay, but take note, when using yung method of section, dapat ikakat mo yung members kung saan tatlong forces lang yung ma-i-expose. Okay, to use the equilibrium equation. Okay, now take note, if we will cut this truss here, pag ganito, apat yung ma-i-expose. So we cannot solve that. Okay, so here, we will solve muna yung member DF. Okay, kasi ito yung katabi ng member FJ. So how to calculate this? Okay, so before that, no, it is best to calculate the length muna dito. Length ng member CJ, EF, FK, and DJ. Okay, magagamit natin yan mamaya. Okay, by using the calculator na lang, we have, take note, this is a line. We can create an equation of the line dyan. So we can use the mode 3-2, linear mode, from the word line. Okay, so we have this in the mode 3-2, we need to use or to locate 2 points lang. Okay, so ganito yung gagawin natin. Ito yung magiging axis natin, reference point. Okay, look at this. When x is 5.8, take note, this is 5.8, our y here is 0. Okay, 5.8 and y is 0, and dito tayo sa reference point. Now, the second point known is dito. Dito na lang sa itaas. Pwede rin dito. Pwede rin dito. Oh, but for me, dito na lang. Okay? When x is, ano yung x natin dito? From here up to this point. That is half of 2 or that is 1. Our y here is tatlong 3.2 or 9.6. Next, after that, press CA sa calculator using the Canon. Okay? Yung updated PRC allowed, no? So, ito yan. After that, you press the CA, then, ganito yung magiging itsura. I-press mo yung this button, the apps button. Okay, next, ito yung lalabas. Then, hanapin mo yung regression, which is at the button 8. Okay, after that, ito yung gagamitin natin, yung X hat. Okay, so X hat. So, if we want to calculate the member CJ, ganito yung lalabas dapat dyan. This is the member CJ. What is the value of X when Y is 3.2? Okay, ito yung ibig sabihin yan. What is the value of X when Y is 3.2? And that is 4.2. Next, we need to calculate this. What is the value of X dito or this member when Y is dalawang 3.2? And that is 2.6. Okay, so ganito yan. The length of CJ or the length of DJ that is equals, that is 3.2 X hat, or we had 4.2. And of the same dito sa member EK and FK. Okay, that is 3.2. Of course, dalawa yan. So we have 2.6 meters. Okay, so distribute natin. Ganyan. Next, first, isosolve natin yung member DF muna. Ito yung best solution talaga. Okay? Excuse me. Now, how to solve that? So, ikakat ko yung truss pa ganito. Okay, pwede ba yan? Pa-curve yung cut? Of course, that is possible. That is very okay. Okay? So, when cutting this, pipili tayo ng section kung ano yung gagamitin natin. It can be dito sa taas or dito sa baba. But for me, mas madali siya dito sa itaas. Okay, look at this. So ganito yung magiging itsura, and we need to calculate this muna, that is FDF. And okay, let's focus na lang in this force. Ayun. Okay, so best option is the moment about C, because as you can see, yung forces na ito is mawawala lang or hindi masasali sa equation. Okay, as you can see, apat yung force na unknown dito, but itong dalawa is collinear man lang, so matatanggal lang din ito. Okay, and the remaining unknown, if you take moment about C, is ito. Okay, but take note, we need to calculate the angle of inclination of FDF. So that is, take note, this is a line, and that line has the same inclination dito sa kabila, which is 63.43 with the horizontal. Meaning, this is 63.43 with the horizontal. Okay. Now, the components here is pa ganito. Let's say ganyan. Okay, let's solve this in this way muna. Okay. I have a summation of moment about C, that should be 0. So, this horizontal force will create clockwise moment about C, that is FDF, cosine of this angle, times the moment arm, 3.2. Okay, that will be clockwise, plus the vertical component, that would be sine of that angle. The moment arm is, take note, from here up to this line dito. Okay, that is 2.6 plus 4.2. Okay, and this also, these forces also will create clockwise moment. So, clockwise silang lahat. Okay, so we have 6 times 3.2 plus 4 times 6.4. Dalawang 3.2. So, we have here negative 5.96 kilonewtons. Okay, so ngayon naman, ipapakita ko sa inyo yung simplified approach dito. Kasi medyo mahaba ito and medyo prone pa tayo sa error sa moment arms. So ito yung gagawin natin. You need to know the principle of transmissibility of the force. And that is, tingnan nyo ha, got this, ita-transfer ko ito dito. Is that possible? Yes, that is possible, because that is in the principle of the force. We can put the force anywhere as long as nasa line of action niya. Ito yung line of action niya. We can put these components here, dito, or anywhere, as long as alam mo yung distance niya, kung saan ka magmo-moment. Well, in this case, it is best na dito natin ilalagay yung components, because as you can see, this horizontal force can be neglected na, because wala siyang moment arm. Okay, and the only remaining force of the FDF is ito na lang, the vertical force. Okay, look at this. Summation of moment about C should be 0. That is this component, FDF sine of that angle, times dalawang 4.2. Okay, that is clockwise moment pa rin. This one naman, wala na siyang moment arm, meaning 0 na yan. Okay, plus 6 times 3.2 plus 4 times dalawang 3.2. Okay, and that will yield the same answer ginawa natin kanina. Okay ba? So that is a very useful principle, no? The transmissibility of the force. Okay, now after that, take note, ito yung goal natin, to calculate the member FJ. So ika-cut natin ito pag ganito. Okay, so exposing the force. Okay, so this is the one we need to calculate. So wala na tayong problema dito. Okay lang yan. So saan tayo magmo-moment in order to calculate the FJ? Na siya na, yung member FJ na lang yung matitirang unknown. Of course, dito sa E, because these two won't create moment about E na. Okay, and the remaining forces to create moment about E is this one and also this one. Okay ba? And take note, sinabi ko kanina, maintain the negative sign of compression. Okay? And wag mo na lang baliktarin yung force para for safe solution talaga. Hindi na ma-confuse. Okay? So, moment about E should be 0. That should be, take note, dito yung force natin inilagay. So, the horizontal component nila is walang kwenta na yan. The vertical component sa lang. Okay? So, and we need to calculate the angle of inclination nito, the FJ. And that is by tangent of this angle is equals to the opposite, which is 3.2 over 2.6. And we have 50.9 degrees. Okay? So, next, moment about E na. And that is FFJ sine of 50.9, the vertical component of that, times the moment arm is 2.6, tapos dalawa siya. Next, plus the vertical component of 5.96, but take note, maintain the negative sign, then sine of 63.43 degrees, and the same moment arm, dalawang 2.6 is 1. Next, plus 4 times 3.2. Okay, so this force won't create moment about Ina. Okay, so that is the answer. Part 3. Okay, so I hope na-enjoy nyo yung presentation natin, no? So, siya nga pala sa mga nagre-request ng mga subjects na gagawin nating solutions, gagawa natin ng lectures, sa, to tell you frankly, no, medyo mahirap sa oras ko kasi these videos nga pala na ini-upload ko dito is parallel sa work ko, kung ano yung topic namin sa school na kung saan ako nagwo-work. Okay, so maybe pag magkakaroon tayo ng mga konting oras lang na vacant time, gagawin natin yung mga request niya. Okay, I hope you understand that. Okay, so thank you for watching and stay safe. Bye-bye.